So there's this guy called Sammy Irungu. He's a really popular Kikuyu gospel singer. Do you guys know him?
No.
Ladies?
That
you don't listen to Kikuyu gospel?
I do. I just don't know him.
Okay. He's known for a popular song which you've said is called My Tears.
Yes.
My Dori Makwa. Can you say that out loud?
My Dori Makwa.
Well done. Very well done. So he's been in the news because apparently a church outed him for conning them. So they had paid him 15,000 shillings to come and perform at the church. Then he didn't show up at the event.
Yeah.
So they released screenshots. Even churches keep screenshots. Mm-hmm. Guys, wow, anything for the tea. So they released screenshots of basically a conversation that they had had with him where they were asking him, why didn't he show up? And he said he was in Dubai, he was stuck, and then so he couldn't make it for the event. They asked him to refund the money, and he now went on to start like abusing them. And he's like, 15,000, first of all, is just pocket change. Like, what am I going to, I'm just going to buy sweets with that money, you know? And then he went on to call the lady that he was speaking to a prostitute. And yeah, I know. And this is apparently a gospel singer. So he said the money is just for buying snacks. He called her a dog.
This is I mean, if you call that someone, that is crossing the line.
Yeah.
It's not just dog.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. And then at the end of the call, the singer said he does not even like singing gospel music and is more into secular music.
What's wrong with
I mean,
I always say this, if you build your brand on what you're not, it's the hardest thing because it's like you're competing against who you are, who you're trying to be. It's just so difficult. Like, and I get people have to do it because they feel like, you know, gospel is where there's money. I don't know if that's a myth and people have just kind of followed it, but a lot of people say that, you know, this is just business, I'm just doing this. But eventually, if you are not being who you are,
This is what happened.
And then, you know what I didn't like about this guy is because don't disrespect people, especially if you're an artist. Don't disrespect and con people, especially not the church. Like, your blessings are far from, like, over. But then, on top of that, like, what I, like, was just so baffled about was the fact that he's like, oh, this is pocket change. This is for candy. If it's if that's what it is, then give the church back the 15,000.
Yes.
Because they worked hard to raise that money. Yeah. And it's, like, a small upcoming church. And they worked hard for that. So, obviously, they need it back.
Yeah, then he was like, no, just call me for an event that you're having soon, then I'll come and, you know, like, perform. And they're like, no, we don't have another event.
First of all,
give me back money.
Why would I or any entity want you back after you called, like, a member a dog in a very bad way, apparently? And, like, also, it's like, they wasted money on you. They're not just going to be like, oh, well, I guess, you know, this guy has an IOU out for us. No, that's not how these things work. Mm-hmm. And if you're going to say that you're like, let's say we take him at his word, right? And he was actually in Dubai for God knows what, because this guy doesn't seem big enough to be in Dubai. But anyway, let's say he's in Dubai for something. You know full well whether or not you're going to take a whole dang airplane back and make an event. No one says, oh, well, maybe I'll make it. No, you know whether you're going to make it. Yeah. So this wasn't like an accidentally, oh, and I just won't give you the money back because F you. This was this guy planned taking this money and running.
Yeah, exactly.
So you are not in Dubai.
And I'm not holding him to the gospel standard because I feel like we're all human. Mm. I'm just holding him from a decent human being standard.
Yeah.
That if you do something wrong to someone and you genuinely didn't know, the response isn't whatever, like, you know, this is not a big deal, it's chicken change or whatever.
Yeah.
The response is, if it's true, you didn't mean to, like, whoa, I'm sorry, like, can I arrange to do this X, Y, and Y date? Because these same people which you are looking down on now, they are the people who are going to do the harambe if God forbid you tumble down from that top, you know?
Yeah.
Remember, there's a TV presenter, he did a fundraising at Kempinski, and we were like, are you being serious?
Yeah,
and it was,
remember,
right?
That.
Him, it's true, he did, and we were like, wait, so, I mean, the plate was like something like, to do 10,000 shillings or something.
Maybe
so
he was in partnership with the hotel.
No,
he
wasn't. But and the thing is, if it's a fundraiser, like, you're open to everyone. My point is, the reputation he had was like uppity when he was at the top.
Yep. Mm.
So when he started tumbling down, everyone just moved back watching him. And people forget that. Today it's me, tomorrow it's you.
Yeah.
So wherever you are, in whatever stage, be respectful of people in down to the top of the ladder.
Yeah.
You'll see.
Yeah. Don't throw stones from glass houses, okay?
But as a singer, do you usually get paid like before a gig, or usually get paid like after
if it's like half, international it's half, they'll give you a down payment like while I'm here, then I'll fly out and then you get the down payment before you go and perform.
But they shouldn't pay you the whole amount.
No, some people ask for the whole amount when they're there before they go on stage.
Okay, yeah.
Like, because which makes then, sense. Yeah, so that we don't have this back and forth, because I've already performed, I've given you the service.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And since I'm here and I'm ready and I'm hyping, it's obvious I'm going to perform. Yeah, actually. Yeah, I think that's a good one.
I can't take it.
Yeah, most definitely. But at the end of the day, humble yourselves. Because maybe you might just be a one-hit wonder. Who knows?